So good afternoon everyone. Today we will be dealing with this histogram equalization. Okay. So what is this basically? We have seen in the histograms what happens is that you may get histogram like this. In R is in the x-axis and then you get histogram something like this. Or whatever architecture you say. Now, histogram equalization is a process by which you transform this histogram in such a fashion that the probability of occurring all the pixel values, it remains same. Okay? The probability of occurrence of all the gray level values, they remain the same. That means all the gray level values, they will be occupied with same number of bins, right? So that is the main understanding. So what do you achieve using this? If you see in many of the in this red line histogram, there are certain regions which are unoccupied, they get occupied, so your contrast of the image, it improves. Okay, another important thing which is there is that, which you should remember is that this histogram equalization was first proposed for the analog images where you are having infinite number of intensity values. Okay, but in the digital image it is only 0 to L minus 1. So this holds true, the equalization holds true over there, because you can adjust all these values and you can make the things flat, this histogram flat. But in digital images, what you will find, it will try to equalize the histogram, but saying this, that we are not having sufficient number of gray level values, what happens? Some will be slightly lower, some will be slightly greater, okay? And some pixels will be unoccupied, some gray level values will be unoccupied also. Okay. So like this. But they will tend to be at a flat line. Okay. It will tend to be a flat line, but it will never be in digital images, it will never be a flat line. Okay, so this is the thing. Another important thing what we say is that once you have equalized the histogram, if I say what happens if you again try to equalize the same histogram, what will happen? Will it go up? Something like this, or will it go down? Something like this, what will happen? It will remain the same because the histogram is already equalized. So again, if you equalize, it will be at the same level. There will be no change. Okay. So that we will be seeing today. First, we will start. We'll be starting with this histogram, which is given, and then we will see. When we perform the histogram again on the equalized histogram, what happens? So for this, what you have to do? We have already seen that how we can calculate the probability distribution function, how we can calculate the cumulative distribution function, that we have already seen. Now, after this, what you have to do is that you have to multiply the cumulative distribution function with L minus 1. Okay, you have to multiply the cumulative distribution function with L minus 1, and we know that the cumulative distribution function at L minus 1 is always 1, and when you are multiplying it with L minus 1, you are basically saying that it will vary from 0 to L minus 1, right? So you calculate these values, you are having this CDF, you are having L minus 1 into C, so you get some values. Okay, now after this you start rounding off these values. Okay, so this one becomes 1, this one becomes 2, this one becomes 5, this one becomes 6, and then you are having 7. Now these are the new gray level values. This should be S. This is the new gray level value S. Okay, so you are having 1. How many pixels are there in 1? There are 10 pixels. You make a ghost table of 0 to 7 and then you try putting this. In 1 you are having 10, in 2 you are having 20, in 5 you are having 30, in 6 you are having 20, in 7 you are having 10. Okay, and in all other gray level values you just simply put 0. Okay, so prepare the first histogram, original histogram, then the modified histogram, do the calculation and find out the modified histogram, and then use this histogram, this modified histogram what you have got, and equalize it again and see what is the result. Okay, it should be same, but you should be confident that yes, it should come same. Okay, so please do this. So our next topic is your histograms matching. Say we want to match the histogram A with histogram B. So what we should do is that first we will go for the histogram equalization of histogram A. Over here you will be getting, and we have already done the histogram histogram equalization. So after the histogram equalization you should get a table like this. Okay, next we will be doing the histogram equalization of the B. Now once you have done the histogram equalization of B, from here we will get an inverse mapping function. This 1 will be mapped to 0, 2 will be mapped to 1. So see, I have written this thing, inverse mapping function, 1 to 0, 2 to 1, then 5 to 2, 6 to 3, 7 to 4. Okay, and rest all other pixel values, they are having a value of zeros over here. So this 7 will be mapped to 4. Suppose you are having 4 and 5, both are having say 7, and you will be having then both 7 7, both 7 values are being mapped to 4 and 5. That is not possible, so you should be taking a value of the highest value in the original gray level value. Okay, so after you have got this function, then you will be taking the equalized histogram of A. Okay, then you should apply the inverse mapping function over there. Then you should apply the inverse mapping function on the equalized histogram. So 1 should be mapped to 0, so 1 it should come over here, but this 0 pixel values, the pixel values over here, you are having 10, so this remain, if you are not using it, then it will remain unoccupied. These pixels will be remaining unoccupied. So you have, you will have to add up this 10, no, 20 plus 10, 30, and it should go to 0 pixel value. Okay, so any pixel, then what is having 2 to 1 over here, under 2 you are having 0, this pixel value is coming over here as 0, then 5 to 2, 5 to 2, but these pixel values are again, they are not being utilized. So you have to add up all these 3 pixel values, and after the addition of this one, it will go to 2. Okay, 5 to 2. Then 6 to 3, 6 to 3, 30. Then 7 to 4, 7 to 4. Okay. Now, if you see what is happening in your. Just a minute. So over here, what is happening in your original histogram of B, you are having 3 pixels at the higher end, they were unoccupied. So after the matching, over here also you are getting 3 pixels are unoccupied. What you are telling?
Sir,
four and
this would also add up.
Ah, 3, 4, and 5. See, 5 is being mapped to 2. So 5 is being mapped to 2. But before that, you are having these two numbers also. So these 3 should be added up. 30 plus 30 plus 20, and then it should go to 2.
But when 6 is mapped to
3,
5 is not adding.
When?
6 is mapped to 3.
Yeah, 6 is mapped to 3. So already you have taken into account, na? 5 has been mapped to 2. Yeah, total number of pixels, it cannot be greater than your pixel values, na? Once you have taken, it's already taken. If it is remaining unused, then you have to add up. Otherwise, why you should take it? 6 to, it is a direct function, 6 to 3. 5 has already been mapped, 5 to 2. So up to this one, you have already used it. Okay. Now in this case, 6 is mapped to 3. So this will come to 3. And then similarly, 7 to 4, this will come over here. Okay. So do this. So you will be getting an idea. The picture will be getting clear. Okay.